Rahul Sivaguru from Motor India. So what you see behind me is the Mugo, which is the electric bus from Green Cell Mobility. Let us have a detailed walk around of this bus. When compared to the frontal part of the vehicle, here we have wipers which wipes in butterfly pattern, and we have mirrors on both the sides which are electrically adjustable, and we have headlamps which are a tripod setup. Basically it's a mix of halogen as well as projector setup, and we do have provisions for fog lamps, and the horn is located at the bottom part of the vehicle, and reflectors are placed on the bumpers of the bus, which is as per bus body norms. And when you move the side of the bus, we have electrically movable doors which has the staircase at which the passengers will get inside the vehicle. And here we have an emergency kill switch in terms of if anything goes wrong. And we have glasses which are with toughened types, not the tinted ones which you see in regular buses. Also, this is part of the bus body norms. And we have the tires which is from Michelin. It's of the X-Multi type, which is basically 22.5 inches. And the profile of the tire is 295 by 80. It's a radial pattern. And we have the rims, which is aluminium or alloy or steel type, which is also catering to the bus body norms. Once you move to the side, you can see precaution stitches at the luggage area. But whichever you see have a sticker like this, it's called the battery compartment, and it's locked by a key, so nobody without a key cannot open it. And the one without stickers are basically the luggage areas where you can store the luggages of the passengers who is onboarding. And you can see a sticker here, so this pad denotes that it's the battery compartment of the bus. And yeah, so the tire specification is common. So what you see at the front is the same as the rear. But yeah, this is a what to say, multi-axle bus, not a multi-axle bus. So this is also having the same Michelin X-Multi 22.5 inches tire. And once you move to the back of the vehicle, here you can see the cooling system of the entire bus. And that in terms of the lighting, you see the tail lamps is the LEDs here, not the headlights. And you have a small luggage area where you can open it. We can see access to the what to say the cooling area, and other wiring related materials are present inside. And as per the bus body norms, you can see this bus has an emergency exit, and the hammer is located just below the emergency exit. And this glass is also not the tinted type; it's a toughened type. And this bus has cameras at both front windshield and the rear windshield, but sadly we don't have 60-degree camera setup. We are inside the interior of this bus. This is basically a sleeper as well as seater type. So I am sitting at the seats which is of the semi-sleeper ottoman type seats, and the above thing of the roof is the sleeper, which is basically a 2-1+1 type, where you can see two passengers can seat compatible in the seat. And that ones at the left are one type, I mean, so it's a one type where one passenger can rest themselves, and we have a ladders to make them go upstairs, and we have access to keep the some things underneath the berth basically. And when you compare to the AC of the vehicle is made by Jetac, and in some other vehicles we can also see Valeo, who is the AC supplier for this bus. And next thing is that in terms of the cluster, we have the onboard system where the battery levels, temperature levels, lubricant levels, the complete range of the vehicle and the state of charge of the vehicle is completely displayed. We do have other provisions basically to say the open and unlock and the doors, and switch on and switch off the lights, switch on and switch off the ACs. So there is provision for all the switches, and predominantly this being an EV bus, we have kill switches to just use it in terms of any emergency situations. And this being built to the bus body codes, you can see the hammers which is located in beneath every windows. And we do have a fire extinguisher setup also present inside. when compared to the normal bus, say the ICE bus, this bus is more or less identical in construction, because the chassis of this vehicle is built by Azad and Veera, who are renowned players in bus body coaches. So basically this is a 12 meter long chassis, and in terms of the seating capacities, this is basically 42 plus driver, this being a seater and a semi sleeper type. And if you compare to the normal bus, which is completely seater, it's 45 plus driver. So that is the difference between the seating capacities of semi-sleeper as well as sleeper buses. And in terms of the battery capacity and the motor capacity, this is powered by a 245 kilowatt motor, which is, has a peak power. And the battery pack of this bus is 630 Ah. So in terms of the performance, this bus is capable of hitting 80 kilometers per hour, which is restricted in terms of the bus body knobs. So in terms of amenities to the passengers, here you can see we have reading lamps as well as AC vents for every individual passenger. And here you can see a cubby hole, which is useful to store the bottles, snacks items, whichever you have in between the travel. And you have curtains to basically get rid of the sunlight and the other things to protect the passengers from it. And you have curtains as well as to make yourself comfortable in the AC bus. And we have pillows to basically rest inside the bus, this being a sleeper. And we, you don't have a pillow facility in the seats, to say. And in terms of other amenities, we have a kill switch here, which basically helps to intimate the driver that the passenger is having some issues with him personally. And this is basically an emergency switch, just to intimate that this passenger in this seat is having some issues. And other than that, you can see a charging port located beneath the seats, which helps to charge your electronic devices on the go, like say a laptop or a phone or a power bank or a TWS headphone, whichever you use it. And in terms of the audio system, you have speakers which is mounted on top of the buses. And say this is the emergency exit, which is built as per the bus body norms. And this is another emergency exit, which helps in terms of emergency situations, evacuation of passengers during emergency situations. And here you have a CCT surveillance, both at the front and rear parts of the bus, inside the cabin, just to monitor if every passenger is seated safely in the vehicle. Fraternity. So we are sitting inside a NewGo bus. This is of the seater and sleeper type. So sitting with us is Ms. Anusha, who is the depot head of NewGo, Tamil Nadu. So hello, ma'am.
Hi.
Hope things are well at your end.
Very well.
Okay. So when NewGo started its operations in Tamil Nadu?
To be on a frank note, we started our operations by last April.
Okay.
May 2023. Exactly, May 26th is what we started our operations at Tamil Nadu.
Okay, yeah, so first anniversary, congratulations.
Note thank in advance. You.
Yeah, thank you. And what are the routes being flared up right now?
Currently, we are flying at Tamil Nadu, at Chennai, Chennai Tirupati, Chennai Trichy, and Chennai Pondicherry, and Pondicherry Trichy, Trichy Coimbatore, and Coimbatore Bangalore, Salem Bangalore, and Chennai Bangalore. And Tiruchi, Bangalore as well. We have multiple routes flying at Tamil Nadu.
Okay. So among these, which are the newer routes which has been added recently?
Okay. Pondicherry just 3 days old. In Chennai, Trichy is again 4 days old in the system. The oldest one is Chennai, Tirupati and Chennai, Pondicherry.
Okay.
Those are the oldest route actually.
So I guess as per the routes which you have mentioned, I guess everything is in the more or less in the fraternity of 300 to 350 kilometers, if I'm right.
Huh, yeah. Exactly, 350 kilometers to 360 is the maximum distance.
Okay. What would be the capacity of the bus running on a single charge, theoretically?
Theoretically, the capacity they say is 320 kilometers,
okay.
But we don't want to risk that. So what we normally do is that by 240, we definitely stop and have a charger.
Okay. So is this procedure involved in routes, say, which is below 200 kilometer per country, say Pondicherry? So do you follow the same procedure in Pondicherry also?
No. For buses flying below 250, we don't charge in between.
Okay.
Only above that, we charge in between.
Okay.
On two grounds, one is to ensure that, see, above 300 kilometers, passengers do need a break. They have to be given a break of a bio break or something.
Okay.
So we stop at that time and then we use that time. We utilize that time to charge our bus.
So what would be that bio break time in between the routes?
See, maximum of minimum of 30 minutes and a maximum of 40 minutes.
Okay.
Depends upon the timing. By late night, nobody would like to go and have their food or something like that. So we restrict at 30 minutes. But in the afternoons, people flying from Chennai to Bangalore definitely would like to want their lunch or breakfast. We can't push them. So that time it would be 40 minutes based on their passengers' comfort.
Okay. So since the time length came into picture, I thought of asking this. So since you said it's 45 minutes. So at 45 minutes, what would be the charge picked up? I mean, what would be the percentage of charge?
That's again depend upon the charge that reaches. Mostly we pick up at least 30 to 40% of the charge.
Okay. And what would be the speed of the bus, ma'am?
Speed is what, I mean, when it comes to Nugo, we are majorly focusing on safety. Safety is our first priority. Then comes anything else. First comes safety, then comes our passenger experience, guest experience, and then comes all other things. First is the safety. So we ensure the buses don't cross 80 km per hour. It doesn't cross. We have a system here monitoring the buses. 24/7 all the buses are monitored. If suppose the buses are flying from Tamil Nadu, so all the buses flying from Tamil Nadu are monitored at one place, Chennai. So we have a dedicated team monitoring that. Even if I fail, we have a team at Mumbai, HO, who monitors that. So we ensure that it doesn't cross 80. The maximum kilometer is only 80.
Okay. And basically, since we are sitting in a seater and sleeper bus, which are the routes this bus applies to?
This bus plies to a longer routes like Chennai Tiruchi, Chennai Bangalore, and Bangalore Coimbatore, Bangalore Tiruchi. Those were the places we run this kind of buses.
But routes like maybe Chennai Pondicherry runs on a
seater basis.
Yes. Yeah. And since you have both the options inside this bus, which is the most sought out after among the passengers?
See, the most sought for longer route is obviously the sleeper thing. But we do have passengers who prefer seater because they don't want to sleep and then they have some work or they prefer a lesser cost.
Okay.
Multiple factors are included in that.
Okay. So what would be the approximate cost difference between the seater as well as sleeper?
Not much actually. Say about 100 to 200 maximum is that.
Okay. And what are the amenities you provide to the passengers in sitting inside your bus, ma'am?
First one is the safety. We do monitor that. We have cameras inside the bus monitoring the safety of the passengers. And number two is that, like, water bottles, wet wipes and all that are provided. And the by default, when it comes to sleeper, blankets, mattress, pillow covers, everything is provided.
And in terms of seating allocation, is any specific seats allotted to a women passenger?
It is not the specific seat. If a passenger, say for example, me by a lady, if I book first, a passenger, say 1B, it is booked. 1C, we will not allow a male to book.
Okay.
So, but if a male is booked in 1B, if a female wants to book, she can.
Okay.
If we will rather ensure that this seat go vacant, but we will not allow the male to book at any point of time.
So, this applies to the sleeper as well?
Yes.
Okay.
If a lady books first, ladies comes first. If a lady books first, we will not allow a male passenger to book.
Okay. And in terms of the booking option, I guess Nugo has a website as well as a mobile booking app.
Yes.
So, what would be the time needed to book a ticket as per your expertise?
You can even book if the seat is vacant. You can even book, say, 11:30 bus need to be at Coimbatore. You can even book at 11:29.
Okay.
So, even 1 minute before, it is allowed.
Okay. And is there any, what to say, since you have providing brakes for the passengers, how well the driver of the bus is taken care of, ma'am?
See, we, for example, this is a longer route. We ensure there are two coach captains. Sorry, we don't call them drivers, we call them coach captains. So, there are two coach captains allocated. So, one coach captain will start from Chennai, for example, Chennai. Till midpoint, the coach captain A will drive. And then he will go and take rest. Coach captain B will resume from that midpoint till Trichy. For example, if a bus runs between Chennai Trichy.
Okay. And speaking on the digital boards, are they bilingual or are they fixed in the same language?
No, it is bilingual. It is when a bus runs between Chennai Trichy, we put it in the regional language as well as in the English. As well as in English because we have people, whoever doesn't know the regional language can take the English. Okay. We keep two languages. One is the regional language and other is English as the common language.
Okay. And in terms of the customer, the passenger follow-up, do you follow any systems where the customer gets a reminder call or a wake-up call or something like that? Because we have seen this amenities in some of the buses.
No, definitely we do that. We have our cabin host traveling in all our buses. Okay. The cabin host calls the passengers before the boarding time. The number is allocated. The cabin host numbers are sent as SMS to all the passengers. So, the cabin host calls the passengers before the start of the journey. So, for example, the bus starts from our depot, it goes to Coimbatore. So, the cabin host calls the passenger and says, ma'am, our buses will reach you at 11:30. Are you ready? Please be ready. Or this is your boarding point. And then, after reaching, also, if the passenger has not come, if the guests have not come, we call them again, we check with them whether they are running. Sometimes the guest will be late or stuck in traffic or they will be nearby. So, to ensure that they are calling, we call them again and check with them when are they coming. And similarly at the drop point, near to the midpoint, we have a speaker system there. The cabin host picks that and informs that the midpoint is nearing. Please be ready and it will be halted for, say for example, for Chennai Pondicherry, it will halt only for 10 minutes. To 15 minutes and Chennai Trichy or Chennai Bangalore, it will halt for 30 minutes. Based on that, they will inform the passengers or the guest actually. And then post that when the drop point is nearby, they will again inform, we are nearing Coimbatore, please be ready because your next drop point is so and so. We inform them.
And the final part of the question. What would be the challenges you face in between a travel or during a travel or in between the operational process, ma'am?
The challenge what we face is that majorly it is the suppose that there is an issue, any bus issue. That is the major challenge we face. And if there is a mechanical failure or any failure in the bus. It is applicable not only to our bus, to any of the bus actually. Only that challenge, but we have the bus immediately available. The spare bus, we do send it so that the guests are not affected. Even worst case scenario, if we couldn't, if the bus is at such a long distance, we couldn't. Then we ensure that the passengers are taken in another, they are provided an alternate and accordingly the amount is refunded.
Okay.
If they feel any inconvenience, then it is taken care of.
And good to know the initiatives being done.
No, we care. Next to the safety comes our guest comfort, which is our priority.
Okay. Yeah. Thanks a lot for your time, ma'am.